Welcome to Positive Atheism English channel. Today I am going to present you the book on Thoughts of Periyar compiled by Dr. K. Veeramani. Buddhism. Periyar on Buddha. Periyar on Buddha. Periyar participated in a function to celebrate the 2501st birth anniversary of the Buddha at Mahabodhi Sangam at Egmore, Chennai on 15th May 1957 and made the following observations. Why do we celebrate Buddha's birthday? Buddha Jayanti does not mean worshipping a picture or an idol of Buddha with camphor, coconut and ashtabuls. It means that we have decided to learn something from Buddha's life and teaching and follow them in our own lives. I am taken for a Nastika. If Nastika means a person who denounces the Vedas, Shastras and Puranas, I am undoubtedly one. I believe it is right and proper for a person of the description to speak on Buddha. A man who believes in the Vedas, Shastras and Puranas must indeed be very clever to speak on an occasion like this. He must be one who is well trained in deceiving the people and one who is hypocrite himself. It is not uncommon for such a man to speak of Buddha as some ancient rishi or mahatma akin to those he reveres. Neither rishi nor mahatma. Buddha was neither a rishi nor a mahatma. He was one who actually opposed the rishi of old, and that is why we are here to celebrate his day. Just as Buddha is no rishi or mahatma, so is Buddhism not a religion in the accepted sense of the word. Many people wrongly regard Buddhism as a religion. A religion must have a god in its center. It must have also things like moksha, naraka, atma, paramatma, papa and punya. To be a great religion, one god is not enough. There must be many of them. These gods must have wives, concubines and all conceivable human relationships. Indians are familiar only with such a religion. Rational thinking, the greatest attribute. To start with, Buddha declared that it is not at all necessary for man to concern himself with God. He wanted people to be bothered with man alone. He did not speak about moksha and naraka. He laid stress on man's character and right conduct. Wisdom, rational thinking, he said, were the greatest attribute of man. A thing is not to be believed in just because a rishi said it or mahatma wrote it. It is absolutely necessary for every intelligent human being to examine a proportion with his own intellect and arrive at the truth himself. Buddhism is therefore not a religion, and we have pleasure in participating in Buddha's birthday only for that reason. Buddha's rationalism called forth a severe reactionary opposition. He lived some 2500 years ago when barbaric practices were the order of the day in India. He stood up boldly against the religion of the day, and the great opposition to his teaching is proof of Buddha's greatness and the power of his world. The people who wrote and speak after him to destroy his rationalist platform tell the tale of the stupendous efforts undertaken to receive the shaken barbaric Hindu religion. Reference in Ramayana about Buddha. The Ramayana has spoken ill of Buddhism. The Ramayana was rewritten to take its later huge proportions to counter Buddha's teachings. The Ramayana, which existed prior to the Buddha, was only a small story. The Vaishnava Nalayar Prabandham, the Saivite Theorem, etc. have taken pains to ridicule and belittle Buddha. The Buddhists and the Jains have been decried as atheists, robbers, murderers, and enemies of Vedic sacrifices. The Shiva Bhaktas have prayed to Shiva to give them the power to molest the wives of Buddhists. The meaning of Nastika. Buddha is ordinarily taken to refer in a person. Buddha means Buddhi or intelligence. Anyone who uses his intelligence is Buddha. All people are endowed with intelligence, but only those who use it intelligently can be Buddhas. The word Siddha conveys a similar meaning. Siddha is one who controls his sense. God Vishnu is the center for Vaishnavism, but for Buddhism, Buddhi or intellect is the center. Today, the word Nastika is made to mean one who denies the existence of God first. But the fact is that one who uses his intellect and logically argues about things is taken for a Nastika. People who denounce Brahmanism are also treated as Nastikas. When Mr. Veeramani spoke, be told that I was a Buddha. In whatever sense he has used the word, I am a Buddha. It is not only so in my care, it is so with everyone who uses the Buddhi in a proper way. Every person who makes a proper use of his reason is a Buddha. Twisted to all terrible meaning. Some time ago, a Buddhist conference was conducted at Erode. The head of the World Buddhist Society, Mr. Mallala Sekara, very nicely said in his opening address that we were all gathered there, so many Buddhas. The Encyclopedia Britannica describes Buddhism as one which calls for the use of buddhi or intellect and which denounces blind belief. Today, intellect is hardly given any place of importance. Schools and colleges do not ask people to use their intelligence and question tradition, reaction, and superstition. If a few do use their intellect, they are immediately branded as a nastika, an appellation that has really no meaning. The rationalist has often to take great trouble to deny that he is Nastika, for the term has been twisted to mean all terrible things. Even the Buddha did not ask people to blindly believe what he preached. He called upon them to weigh his words, shift them according to their intelligence, and accept that the part of them which appeared to them to be reasonable. Thank you.
Please download Samaram multi-channel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels. For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.